Geraldine Drew, and I'm a librarian here at the State Library of Queensland. I'd like to begin the Siganto Foundation Artists Book Lecture Series with a performance by one of our fellows, Clyde McGill. Clyde describes himself as an artist, however, he's much more than that. So, without further ado, I'd like to ask Clyde to talk about his fellowship, his book, and he's produced the most exquisite book for our collection called Seven Conjectures on Looking for Place. So, over to you.
Thanks very much. Thanks, Christine. Christine's going to dance in a minute. She's done some steps practice. So she's just going to stay up there with me, so she can dance. If you don't have a seat, if you'd like to come up here, could you do? Because my original idea was that you would be up here. Yep. Director, so what's happened here, I must say, is that the... you know, I've been doing this fellowship now for a year, and this is the end of it, right? So this is my last talk as a fellow for the State Library, and so I'll fit after tonight. I officially get off the security naughty list if they start again. But what's happened is, you know, there's been a man here who I met in the, you know, the Oxley research group. What do you call it? Christine said she'd stay here and answer my questions.
Collections reading group.
Yeah, that one. Well, when I first came here, I met a man, and I wrote about him in my blog, you know. I'm not sure what his name was, but I called him All One Word, because he told me his name, and then he said it was All One Word. No caps, no spaces. So I called him All One Word. And he's contributed to my fellowship. You know, he heard what I was doing, and he's kept contributing to it. And he was here. But he's not turned up now. I told him one day. He's not turned up. So, but it left me, he brought stuff, because he was going to talk about the stuff that he contributed. So I have my book that I made, but I've also got his stuff. So I'm going to, for better or worse, I'm going to kind of try and tell you about his stuff, right? And we might get to my stuff. How's that? And I also have some, so I'm not sure what's in here, but just bear with me, right? I'll probably have a bit of a... So it's always taking photos. Maybe I should I open this book, because it's got some content for it, I suppose. This is the book that I actually made. He didn't make, I made, but he contributed to it, right? Just so you know, there's a book at the end of this somewhere, or somewhere in this. So. There is a book.
It's a
beautiful you can dance any time you want. So one of his ideas was that he would bring me things and say, this is, you're looking, see, my project was looking for Queensland. And I realised that as I looked for Queensland, I was really looking for place in a very, you know, much broader sense than that. So it's about looking for place. So he sent me things, and he would bring me things about looking for place, which some of it was quite a crap, you know. But some of it was very good. Some of it, you know, was... And he would always bring me, you know, bits of stuff like this. And, they're nice, aren't they? Is that a cook tree? I think that's a cook tree, isn't it? You like purple? He pressed them. I think there's more in here, but... And all his bookmarks are made up of maps because he's of the mistaken impression that maps are about place. They're not, are they? The maps are just maps. Nan brought me this. This is Edwardian photographs from something. So he brought me these photos because he thought that was one's of the Middle East somewhere and one's of the Nile or something. So he would bring. He thought that was exciting. So anyway, I just had a thing together. He also said that place was had something to do with mathematics because, you know, it is, you can measure where a place is. I don't think you can. I'm just talking about what he brought me. I don't think it is about measuring for a moment, is it? You know, like, place is about a lot more than that. And he left me a... This is the mathematics, you know. Is it? Do you like those little bookmarks? This is so I knew where Queensland was. It made a little bookmark there. A map of Queensland. See that? But I just wanted to bring you, this was one of the set questions, set answers that he said. If rainfall on a certain place is 35.6 inches a year, how many gallons per acre is this equal to if 1 gallon equals 16 cubic feet? 1.6 cubic feet. And then he said, go and find a place that's got a rainfall of 1.16 cubic feet and you'll be there. I could go on. But he might say another. If you see him, don't give me a nod because he'll get really mad. One of the things that I did was with this book was I really felt like you can't talk about place in Australia in any sense, right, without talking about the original owners of this land. So, and I thought one of the things that I could do is make a little book. So the book has a little book, right? So it's a book within the book, and it has the acknowledgement written into it. And you've read it though, haven't you? Yeah. Yeah. So I won't read it again. But this is just a form of the acknowledgement that's in the first part of it. So it was very interesting in bunya pines. And I got me a bunya pine. I lived in it quickly, aren't they? Lived for 500 years, been around since 250 years ago, up in Mesozoic era, since dinosaurs. And I talked to him one day about that. Actually, he said that I talked to him about how bunya pines, because he liked bunya pines so much. But this, the other thing that he really likes is mangroves, because he says mangroves define a place as well. So, princely mangrove leaves. But he brought me this, when I told him the bunya pines were the dinosaurs were there, was at the same place then, like 250 million years ago, another bookmark, but he brought me this because it showed him that there's dinosaurs here in Queensland. Well, I knew that.
What are you giving me now?
No, I didn't say I didn't give you any. Four leaves. Oh, no, leaves, this was like... So I'll show you the book. Can you see it? Stairs. So this is part of the book. It's divided up into conjectures because I thought that you'd have, if you're asking what is place, then you have questions about place, right? And so I said that I had kind of seven questions or seven conjectures about place that I didn't know the answer to. So I divided the book up and I said that I'm place. Because I think a place probably is defined by us, right? And it's defined by these kind of things, right? Where you are, who you love, who loves you. So, so he brought me this, which was the diamond bracelet that is, like, it comes out of his family somewhere. I think it was belonged to his sister or something. Look at it, it's beautiful. Yeah. So, yeah, look at it. Anyway, he said that was love and that was place as well. So, shall I continue with this or would you rather have a look at the book later? So conjecture number two talks about kind of the future, you know, what is a place the same in the future? And if we look from a place into the future, is that the same? And there's a kind of metaphysical seer who runs through the book. I think Eddie Marbo probably was absolute seers. Conjecture number three has thylacines in it. Because when I looked at what a thylacine is, there's been a lot of thylacine here, right? In Queensland. There's certainly thylacine petroglyphs in the top of Western Australia, which are like 3,000 years old. About the same here. Before the climate change back then. And of course in New Guinea, probably. New Guinea's one of the places where you can probably see thylacines today, I would think. It was he brought me this book on birds, Brisbane birds. Because I look a lot of you know that I watch birds here, but I think birds are an interesting part of the place. And among the migration of birds is a fascinating part of the place, right? It's got some other stuff in there. So he's got some of this stuff. No, I'm just kidding. It's probably from the Kuru Mahalas.
The telegraph.
Oh, the telegraph. Does the telegraph still exist in that? So what star is it? That's the... So you thought that contributed to the place as well, right? But when you look out, you've got to be in a certain place to see where that is. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Thanks. So there's a few of those, so if you want to have a look, they're all from the end of 1979. There's one from early 1980. This was the bird. You know the little black and white bird that goes around the place? So, in the intro, we did a project on the bird because the bird, where the bird lives, is so important, isn't it? So, you can have one of these if you like, or you could show them to someone else who's sitting next to you. Don't feel like you have to. Beautiful bird, isn't it?
Yeah, this is why
the Goodwill Bridge. Yeah, so I went and asked them, could we borrow the Diamantina, because we're going down the Diamantina. Makes sense. And the man was very, very obstructive. Very obstructive. I mean, for, you know, courteous, we were courteous. Anyway, this is where we went. This is our boat here. And this is where we went down the Malone and the Culgoa and the Diamantina. And we had wheels on the boat. But when we got down there, we had lunch at the inn, we had a counter lunch, you know. And then we were coming back up the river, and all one word missed the turn off. We finished up, I think, in the Culgoa. We finished up at Dirabandi, right? The boat sank at Dirabandi because he's getting out papers about what bird this was on the bank of the river. Missed the thing, the boat sank completely. The policeman was really upset because he said we shouldn't be doing that because it was endangered. Anyway, this is he was going to tell you that story. Because the interesting thing about, you know, there's a lot of rivers here in Australia that are like 150 years plus old. Now if you go out to the Finn, I went, as part of this project, I went and slept in the Fink River for a couple of nights. The Fink River's been there for 300 to 400 million years. Like where we slept in the river. So it's very old. So it's a place, right? And I think this is this was the Torres Strait Indigenous language from the east side of Torres Strait, and these words were collected by the writing is here in the library of this man from 1860, right? And he collected the indigenous language that described the boat, you know, in all its parts or its new. And so I collected his words from here. And then I have a friend who lives in the Torres Strait Island, indigenous woman. So I went and ran the letters, words past her and said, what is this? She said, oh, that's a canoe, I know that. And that language is still very, very relevant today. So I used it in the book. And final part, because I put a prologue but in, the final part of it is a coda which talks about place as a parallax, and you know, the parallax is, you know, when I look from here I can see something, but when I look from there, like points to you, you see different from there. And I thought it was about place, and the end of it is about the moon, and about deities or about some spirits within the landscape. And it still hasn't turned up, and I think I've shown all this stuff, so there we go.